Welcome, brothers and sisters, to another installment of the IAFF educational series on building construction and the importance of knowing your work environment. One of the responsibilities of today's fire service is to develop pre-incident planning. These can include systems such as fire protection systems, sprinkler systems, standpipe systems, understanding means of egress, understanding the protection of structural members and the performance of structural members under fire conditions. Another issue that is facing the fire services in today's environment are the performances of the facades of today's structures. As we have seen in recent incidents over the last few years worldwide, this can be a great concern, and if these facades are not installed correctly or tested correctly, they can result in tragic consequences. We're going to turn to our partners at Underwriters Laboratories, or UL, to start to understand how we test these facades under fire conditions and what the fire service should be concerned about, and during our pre-incident plannings, the questions the fire service should be asking of those building managers or building owners, so we can understand what resources that we need to deploy and what tactics we need to develop to bring these incidents to a successful conclusion. I would like to invite my colleague at Underwriters Laboratories, Mr. Dwayne Sloan, to discuss the testing of combustible facades on today's buildings.
Flammability on exterior walls or combustible facades is a growing global concern. If you look at situations that happened in Melbourne, the Torch Tower in Dubai, followed by the Address Hotel as the fireworks display was happening on December 2015. This fire called global worldwide attention. Following that, we had the fire in Grenfell Tower in London, where 72 people lost their lives. This has caused a growing concern in the US as well, and caused more of a focus on fire test standards and methods used to evaluate exterior walls. One of the factors that drives exterior wall construction is the different requirements and the balance of requirements that you'll find in the codes. For example, in order to achieve thermal performance, you have to use different types of insulation. There's the use of weather-resistant barriers and also the exterior veneers or facades themselves. All of these have to work together to complete a full exterior wall construction. So the tests that are used to evaluate exterior facades is NFPA 285, Fire Propagation Test Method for exterior walls containing combustible components. It's the key test method that you'll find throughout the codes in the US. It's important to understand that the test method, NFPA 285, is a test of the complete wall construction. It's not just a test of the individual components alone. So the whole wall has to be assembled just as it's going to be assembled in the field, as you'll see in the test today. So these tests are normally required in buildings of certain types of occupancies, types 1, 2, 3, or 4, especially when those buildings are over 40 feet in height. So this test method evaluates the fire propagation on the outside of the building. So what we do is we use a two-story structure that represents two stories, a floor and a second floor, and it's called the ISMA, the Intermediate Scale Multi-Story Apparatus. In this test method, we have a burner that's in the first floor, and then we measure the fire as it comes out of a plume through the actual opening on the exterior wall assembly. The whole point of the test is to determine that combustibles on the second floor would not be ignited. So one of the modes of failure in this test method is movement of the flame up the wall no higher than 10 feet on the assembly, or lateral movement no more than 5 feet from the center line of the assembly. So of course one of the modes of failure is flame propagation up the exterior of the wall. But also one of the modes of failure is if there's a cavity or an airspace in the assembly, fire can move within that airspace. In this test setup, instrumentation will tell us whether we have flaming inside the wall cavities or not. So the minimum test specimen size for NFPA 285 is roughly 17.5 feet high by 13.5 feet wide. As you'll see, the test specimen has a window opening that measures 78 inches wide by 30 inches high. The first floor room burner delivers a controlled flame through that opening in the window. And at 5 minutes into the test, the window burner is rolled up to the assembly to also add an exterior fire component. As the fire comes out of the window opening, you'll see it lap up about 3 feet or so above the window opening. The whole objective is to prevent combustibles that might be on the second floor from igniting. The intent of the test is to prevent leapfrogging in an actual building where the fire goes from one floor to the next floor. As we've seen in building fires all around the world, the fires went from one floor to the next floor and raced up the outside of the building. The system that we see in this test is a full wall assembly from the inside to the outside. It starts with the interior gypsum board, of course the steel studs with an open cavity, no insulation in the cavity. It has exterior sheathing covered by a weather barrier, a 3-inch airspace, and then the exterior veneer, or what we are calling the ACM. So for the ignition, you see that we actually ignited the gas burner that is on the first floor. You'll see that most of the flaming is limited to the first floor room. At roughly 3 minutes and 15 seconds, you can see burning at the windowsill. This is more than likely attributed to combustible off-gassing of the different combustible components. At 5 minutes, you see that flaming is beginning to come out of the window opening, and we ignite the window burner. At roughly 6 minutes, we see flaming at the windowsill on both the floors and the sides. At 8 minutes, you'll see that there's warping at the panels at about the 3-foot level up from the opening. That means that the panels are beginning to react to the heat intensity from the ignition flame. At approximately 11 minutes, you'll see that the aluminum flashing has been lost, and there's also flaming at the upper windowsill. At 14 minutes, we are now over the 1,000 degree test criteria that's found in NFPA 285. At this point, the test would be considered to be a failure. Also, we see that flame propagation has reached the 10-foot level, which is another pass-fail criteria of NFPA 285. As you can see, the flame progresses very rapidly once the exterior aluminum veneer has been burned off, exposing the polyethylene core. At approximately 16 minutes, we've decided to discontinue this test based upon the flames going all the way to the top of the test specimen. This second test assembly is very similar to the first, with the only difference being the exterior cladding, or the ACM. This ACM, it has a limited combustible core and is expected to give very different results. So let's get the test started. At time zero, we see the ignition. We ignite the room burner. The system, very similar to the first one, has interior gypsum, studs, no insulation in the cavity, exterior sheathing, weather barrier, mineral wool insulation, 3-inch airspace, and the limited combustible veneer. At 5 minutes, we ignite the window burner. At 8 minutes, we see warping at the panels at about the 3-foot level up from the opening. This test has passed NFPA 285 for the complete 30-minute duration, complying with the temperature requirements and the flame propagation requirements. Very different from the first test that was stopped at 16 minutes due to flame propagation, this showed a very different performance and acceptable performance, with the only change in the two assemblies being the ACM panels. Some of the things that firefighters may want to understand during their pre-incident inspection is, what is the building type? The building type is going to dictate what the codes say about the fire testing. What is the occupancy type? What are the materials that the building is made out of and the exterior facade is made out of? Whether or not those materials have or have not been fire tested. You also want to pay attention to horizontal breaks, and are there horizontal breaks, and maybe inspect the joining mechanisms. There are a lot of different fire tests that are used in the built environment, and it's important to understand which fire test was used to evaluate the exterior wall assembly. And other information such as, is there insulation used and what type? Are there weather barriers used, and exactly what type of facade is being used?
As you can see, the modern built environment is a complicated environment. There are many factors driving the design and construction of today's buildings. There are environmental concerns. There are design and aesthetic concerns, and there are also structural protection concerns. These require multiple approaches, but the one consistent approach is the responsible design, installation, and maintenance of these exterior facades. These facades have to be properly designed and installed in order to protect not only the occupants, but the responding firefighters. Both UL and the IFF encourage firefighters to ask questions during their pre-incident inspections. Understand the type of system that was installed in that wall. understand the components that were involved in that system, understand how that system was installed, and more importantly, how is that system tested, and was it tested to the proper fire exposures? It is incumbent upon the fire service to understand our work environment so we can properly design our tactics and our responses to bring these situations to a successful conclusion. These successful conclusions will not only protect the occupants, but they'll protect the structure, and more importantly, they'll protect that responding firefighters so they can operate more effectively and more efficiently. From UL and the IFF, stay safe.